Good evening. I'm Kate Markert, Executive Director at Hillwood Estate Museum and Gardens, and it's my pleasure to welcome our members to an intimate cello performance. In this unsettled time, I'm especially grateful for your continued support of Hillwood. I'm pleased to be cautiously welcoming visitors back to the estate and the museum spaces. I invite you to come explore the absolutely stunning summer gardens. The mansion in Dacha, which houses the special exhibition Natural Beauties, Exquisite Works of Minerals and Gems, are also open. At this point, advanced reservations by timed entry are required. You can find more information, including temporary visitor guidelines, and make your reservations online. Tonight's program, presented by cellist Ignacio Alcover, came about as musicians across the globe have sought ways to provide light, love, inspiration, and to be inspired by others. While concert halls sit empty during the coronavirus pandemic, the rich human contact between musicians and audience members thrives in unique venues. While some artists have taken to their balconies, others have played to potted plants, and still more are streaming performances from their living rooms. We come to you tonight from a somewhat grander location, Marjorie Post's Pavilion at Hillwood. She was, of course, a great supporter of the National Symphony Orchestra and served on its board for more than three decades, beginning in 1942. In addition to her own season tickets, Post regularly purchased gift subscriptions and single tickets in bulk so her friends and family members could also enjoy performances. In 1956, Marjorie Post funded the inaugural season of the National Symphony Orchestra's Music for Young America series, a program which continues today. The five-week season provided students visiting the nation's capital the opportunity to experience the country's rich cultural arts in addition to the halls of government. Post's fondest wish was that thousands of young people who attend the concerts would return to their homes throughout the country with a desire to hear more of the world's fine music. She hoped it would promote small community orchestras in communities across the United States. In 1967, a Music for Young America concert was recorded on the White House lawn, reaching a wider audience, through later public television broadcasts. Following that tradition, tonight's live-streamed performance bears the impact of the novel coronavirus. Ignacio Alcover will perform for a live audience member of one, Hillwood's head of facilities and maintenance, Brian Greenfield. When Ignacio approached me with the desire to play for Hillwood, he wanted to perform for a single person. We decided to open this experience up to essential staff who have been reporting on site throughout the pandemic. Ignacio has not met and does not know Brian. He will not be playing his favorite pieces, but instead will select works from memory, inspired by his experience, looking at the individual seated before him. This may sound familiar to dedicated fans of the At Home section of the Sunday New York Times. We were inspired by the Stuttgart State Orchestra and the Southwest German Radio Symphony Orchestra's community outreach. As with those experiences, Brian has been asked simply to sit before Ignacio and make eye contact for 1 minute. They will leave at the end without exchanging words or applause. Ignacio Alcover was born in Barcelona and is the founder and artistic director of Musica Aperta, an organization that makes music more accessible and alive to diverse audiences, including students, casual concert goers, and classical music aficionados. He is a member of the Kennedy Centra Opera House and Washington National Opera Orchestra, and has performed throughout the United States, Europe, and the Far East. Ignacio was the soloist in the Boston premiere of Tout un monde lointain by Henri Dutilleux for cello and orchestra, and has recorded for Centaur Records and Forte labels. Live radio performances include France Musique, Radio Nacional Española, and National Public Radio in Washington, D.C. He has appeared in concert and recorded with ensembles that range from the 21st Century Consort to the Thievery Corporation. Always introduced in collaboration and sharing, Ignacio has taught cello and chamber music for most of his professional career. He has served on the faculty of the Peabody Institute of the Johns Hopkins University, Hood College, and the Baltimore School for the Arts, and served as chairman of the faculty at the Washington Conservatory of Music. He has taught master classes in Korea, as well as in Laos and Spain. As the artistic director of the group Musica Aperta, he created the educational show, The Struggles of Mr. M, which under the auspices of the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts has been performed over 100 times in the elementary and middle schools of Washington, D.C. He currently teaches at George Mason University. Ignacio has been a longtime supporter of Hillwood, and his late wife, Liana Paredes, was chief curator until her death in 2017. I hope this intimate performance gives you the opportunity to step out from your daily duties and routines and connect with us virtually. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.